This screencast is going to go over a phase diagram for a ternary system. So we could take something that's partially miscible, three species, water, acetone, and MIBK, and we could represent them here by this triangular phase diagram. All right, now it's important to notice that this particular phase diagram is for a system where the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. Now, two things could happen when we mix these three species together in a liquid form. One, they could remain as a single phase, or two, they could separate into two phases. And this all depends on the amounts of each species in the solution. For example, if we were to make a solution that we'll call solution A, and we'll say that it is 70% acetone, 10% water, and 20% MIBK, we could plot exactly where the solution is in the phase diagram. I'm going to use a highlighter to do this. You can see that as we increase up towards acetone, the top of that triangle would represent a 100% acetone solution. So 70% would be somewhere along this line. If we do the same thing for water, a 10% solution of water would be somewhere along this line. And then a 20% solution of MIBK just so happens to fall where these two already intersect. So we would represent this point, solution A, right there. Now, as you can see, this is outside of this envelope region. We'll call this region 1. Well, when any solution falls in region 1, it stays as a single phase liquid. So the other thing that could happen is if we fall under that envelope. So let's make up a solution that might do that. Let's say solution B is 33% by mass. Again, all of this is by mass. 33% acetone, 33% MIBK, and 33% water. Otherwise, an equal mass ratio of all three species. Now, when we look at the lines here, 33% is going to fall somewhere above that 30 line. MIBK is going to be somewhere along their 30 line, and water somewhere in front of its 30 line. This falls exactly dead center of the triangle for this phase diagram, so we'll draw it right around there. Now the trick here is, as I mentioned, it separates into two phases. These lines that you see are known as tie lines. They connect compositions of the two liquid phases in equilibrium. You basically go to each side following those tie lines as guides. So if we do that, we're going to come along here to this side and up here to this side. And just as a disclaimer, reading any kinds of diagrams or plots can be a little open to interpretation. So hopefully our answers are somewhat similar to each other's. This is going to be known as the water-rich phase because it's heavy in water. And this is going to be known as the MIBK-rich phase because it's obviously heavy in MIBK. So now we read these two separate plots. For the MIB, it looks like about 53% MIBK. And then if we read the acetone, we're going up in the plot. So we got 10, 20, 30, just under 40. So we'll say, I don't know, maybe around 38 weight percent. At this point, you could just add them up to 1. Now if we go towards water, I think weight percent looks pretty good. So that's the MIBK's rich phase. The water rich phase, we just go to the other side and we're going to look, and it's about, I'm going to say 67% water. And then we go up towards acetone, so that's about a little higher than 25, somewhere between 25 and 30. So we'll say 28 weight percent acetone. That leaves us with 5 weight percent MIBK, which is right around that line. So that looks pretty good. So we started with the equal mass of each species, and when they phase separate and reach equilibrium at 25 degrees Celsius, we get two phases with the following compositions.